And for me, I've always, you know, probably prided myself on, you know, always getting, you know, right down into the heart of the business, you know, walking the stores, jumping behind the register, throwing a truck at night, you know, those kinds of things that I've done. And when I stepped back, I said, I would have never imagined that we have so many employees at risk who haven't been heard and listened to and seen, because the social unrest that we saw that happened with the murder of George Floyd said that we weren't listening as a country, right? We weren't paying attention. We were likely looking at numbers. We were likely moving, you know, in spaces that weren't relevant, right? All of us have been on this huge technology journey, right? And that's all we can think about is fast pace. But at that same time, we were leaving people behind. And for me, it's a time for leaders like myself and others, take a deep breath, think about what next generation work is going to be like. This is more than a discussion of the future of work. It's more about how do we want to make people feel so that they are naturally motivated to be their best. And when they define that for all of us, then what do we do about it, right? So how are we going to get people educated? You know, how do we handle the rising cost of, you know, higher education? Or do they have to be educated? You know, I think about the apprenticeship model that, you know, many of our parents and grandparents came from. You know, my dad learned masonry, brick masonry, from his brother who learned it from his uncle who learned it from my grandfather, right? And so that was their side gig, you know? And so what do we do? How do we create that again at scale? Because that's what people want to do. They want to live through their life in terms of what they're passionate about. It might look like education comes with it. It might look a lot of different ways, but what are we going to do as leaders to help people fulfill their dreams and be the best they can be?